Oh, okay. That was good. Hello. 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 Hi, my name is Balaji Padnala. I'm from Freescale, working as a principal staff systems and architecture. So today I'm going to take you through network service insertion and chaining using OpenStack. So this is the agenda we have. First I'll take you through the overview, and then network function virtualization and SDN. And we'll go through the cloud resource discovery and OpenFlow controller. And we have a couple of components in OpenFlow controller, CRM consumer, a flow manager. And then we'll see network service insertion and chaining, and the future work summary. And then we have questions. So let's see the overview. The need of network services in the cloud environment, like we have the scalability, elasticity, and service velocity, and enabling a wide variety of ecosystems. So right now we have all the commercial hardware where you have to buy with a lot of money so that they'll be deployed in your data centers using cloud. And when you want to install a new service, the time to required to get the new service into the deployment takes more than switching the hardware and then making it suitable for the cloud deployment. And if you want to increase the have the scalability and elasticity, and again the same, the time for the project, it takes more when compared to the hardware. So the network services using network functions using virtualization. Okay, so there we can have we can reduce the time for service velocity, and we can have scalability and elasticity as well. So multiple deployment use cases for a tenant, like application development and entire application architecture, and we have a hybrid cloud deployment. So based on the tenant requirements, we can deploy these network services. For example, we have a three-tier web services tier and application tier and database tier. And we have different network services required to handle the traffic coming onto the web tier, and then the traffic generating from web tier to the application tier. And again, from application tier to the database tier, the entire application architecture. And also we have the hybrid cloud deployment where we have multiple R&D applications running in the cloud, and we have the web servers running for general purpose use for the customers, like that. So the need of network services for these different tiers are different as such. So just I'll give a glance at the OpenStack. Like, we have multiple components of OpenStack, like Horizon, Keystone, and we have Nova. We have Nova Scheduler, RabbitMQ server, and we have Nova API and Nova Compute. And we have Neutron for network function, network virtualization, and connectivity services. And we have Glance for image storage, and retrieving the virtual machine images. And we have other components like Cinder, Horizon, and Keystone for authentication. And Horizon is for the dashboard where we can configure the services and networks. And we have a Cinder for object storage. So what is the network function virtualization? Like, how do we virtualize the network function? So running any network function within a virtual machine, for example, let us take an open source software like HAProxy. It's a server load balancer, which we can run it inside the virtual machine. And we can run for IP tables firewall. We can use it as a virtual firewall, network function virtualization firewall. Similarly, we can use any VPN applications as such, like IPsec, et cetera. So basically, it reduces the expenditure and operational expenditure. That is the primary advantage. And we can replace the custom hardware replacement. Like, we don't need any specific branded networking gear, where we can use the existing virtualized environment, virtual server environment, to deploy these network services into the tenant networks. And we have SDN networks and non-SDN networks. Like, network function virtualization doesn't need as such SDN networks, like software-defined networks. It can work on non-SDN networks as well. And NFV appliances deployment is very much complementary to SDN networks, because the SDN networks give the flexibility of network abstraction, where we can use this network abstraction to deploy these NFVs, and they are very well together, complement each other, these two technologies. So the network and application deployment without the need for upgrades of network devices. Like, we don't need to upgrade, if you want to increase the capacity. Like, you don't need to upgrade a new device as such, but you just need to change the image itself. That's enough. So we have tremendous advantages on having the NFV. And the coming up, the SDN networks are complementing this NFV deployments, where we can save a lot of money, and we can definitely showcase a better performance. So the NFV challenges we have is the performance, first of all. So when we say that network function virtualization, the network function running on a specific hardware versus the network function running inside a virtual machine. So obviously, we have lot of bottlenecks where the packets going through the hypervisor and then the virtualization library and then to the virtual machine, the function inside the virtual machine running. And again, due to this, the deploying of these network services, the backend applications which the end user is going to access. So the impact of performance of network function directly gives impact on the access performance of the application as such. Performance is the major challenge. And we have another challenge, like migration. So we have the application migration, where whenever the application migrates from one cloud to the another cloud, or the policy changes which required for these network functions, those policy changes as well has to migrate along with the application. So migration is another biggest challenge to implement these network function virtualization. And we have non-SDN networks for scale up and scale down, and automatic initialization of network services based on traffic load. Like the elasticity, where the traffic is low, we don't need the network services, the many network services. So we can have a few firewalls running, and we have a heavy load running into the system. We can scale up these network services based on the traffic patterns to the cloud of the tenant. So what is the, this is the cloud resource data. So we'll see the software defined networking. So what is the cloud resource data? The cloud resource data is the events events generated when we when we launch a virtual, when we spin a virtual machine, or when we create a network, and you know, any other, like when you add a network, when you create a port, when you delete a port. So these are the different events, and the data generated along with these events are very useful. Like it's so we have the again the OpenFlow protocol for SDN, software defined networking. Like we can define the networking, like how do we want to do with the data. When we create a network, okay, we will store that network data into a database, and we can take the appropriate action based on that data. The intelligence built surround the data is very much important. So for defining the networking, so the real meaning of the software defined networking, like we have to define the networking, like we have to program the network. And how do we program the network? We need the data which is required, and we want to use the data in a specific manner, you know, based on our requirement, based on the tenant requirements. For example, scaling up the network services, scaling down the network services, similar to that. And we have the compute events and data. For example, like whenever we create a virtual machine, the data will be generated, like what is the compute host on which the VM is getting created, and what are the host node details, what is the capacity of the host node, and what is the storage of the, what is the RAM, what is the CPUs, and all the host node details. And whenever a new host is added into the network, into the data center, and that details as well required to store in the cloud resource data. And we have network events and data, for example, like creating a network, creating a subnet, and creating a port, and creating the VXLAN ports on OES in a compute node. So these are the different data events and data which we are going to collect together and build an intelligence, and we will define the networking for launching these network services and chain. So this is the high level picture of cloud resource data. We have the cloud resource Nova and Neutron. Nova is for the spinning up the VMs, and we have Neutron for networking. And we have the cloud resource data, which is required where we are going to capture all the events generated by these two components. And we're going to store that data into the cloud resource derivation service database. And then we have, if you see in the picture, we have the OpenFlow controller. And we have the OpenFlow controller, and we have the another component called CRD consumer, which is required for capturing this data generated from the OpenFlow OpenStack controller to the OpenFlow controller. And we have the different compute nodes connected to the OpenStack controller using Open vSwitch. So all this data communication, the communication between the cloud resource data and OpenFlow controller is through the message queues. We have the RPC JSON messages, and we have different notification fanout exchanges, where we will create the queues to capture this data from the cloud resource data to the OpenFlow controller. So we have the network service infrastructure where we can create the chains, network service chains, and we can launch the network service chains integrated into the cloud resource data as a plugin. And we have two different features, like layer 2 chains and layer 3 chains. And we have the CRD consumer, where we will consume the data generated by this Nova Neutron through the cloud resource derivation service to the CRD consumer. So the cloud reserves data are relay, like the data which is captured from these events, these are relayed to the cloud reserves data consumer, where through the notification fanout exchange, the OpenFlow queue for tapped Nova and Neutron messages, and fanout queue for each OF controller. Like, we can have multiple OpenFlow controllers also deployed in your network. So there is a common queue for the management messages from OpenFlow controller to the cloud resource discovery. And we have the cloud resource data consumer, where there is a direct interface between this cloud resource data consumer to the OpenFlow controller, so that the data collected from CRD, cloud resource data of OpenStack controller, will be passed on to the OpenFlow controller. The CRD consumer will receive JSON messages from CRD service. All the events are through the JSON messages, where that JSON message can be converted into the messages which are required for the OpenFlow controller. Like, we can have OpenFlow controller like OpenDaylight or any third party or any commercial vendor as such. Just we have to write the corresponding driver where these JSON messages are converted into the messages which can understand by the OpenFlow controller. And the CRM consumer configures this OpenFlow controller database. It configures all the data received, generated from the OpenStack controller using the integration API. So we'll see the CRD consumer on the OpenFlow controller, where there is a REST API interface between the CRD and OpenFlow controller. The initial messages, like whenever the OpenFlow controller comes up in the network, the initial messages will be sent to the OpenStack controller cloud resource derivation service, where it will store all the OpenFlow controller information in its database, and integration of OpenFlow controller application service. The OpenFlow controller can have multiple applications as such, like it can have L4, L7 applications also in OpenFlow controller. And also we have the version control mechanism, where the configuration versioning also is maintained in the database. The integration drivers for vendors specific are open source OpenFlow controller like OpenDaylight. So where it's not only a specific OpenFlow controller, we can have it for the any commercial vendor as such, a vendor OpenFlow controller, where we have to write our own drivers to integrate, to capture this data and configure the OpenFlow controller. So this is another component, like Flow Manager. Flow Manager application, OpenFlow controller application service, where this OpenFlow controller application service is a REST API interface to capture the data and configure the OpenFlow controller. The configuration of cloud resources, like whatever data captured during from Nova Neutron through the cloud resource data, can be configured into the OpenFlow controller. And we have another database running in the OpenFlow controller where we store all this data, and we have versioning support. The Flow Manager, like the configuration of these events from OpenStack controller and putting it in the database of OpenFlow controller, the events generated from those configuration of database in the OpenFlow controller will be given to the Flow Manager, where the Flow Manager will build the intelligence, like creating the flows on the OPN OES switch on the compute nodes. So based on this, the virtual machine data, VM data from Nova, and networks and ports data from Neutron will be stored in the OpenFlow controller, and OpenFlow controller, the Flow Manager in the OpenFlow controller will capture that data and create the flows required and configures the Open vSwitch on the compute nodes. So we have the network service insertion and chaining. I think I've gone through this. Yeah. So we have the virtual network topologies, the layer 2 and layer 7 networks. The tenant network isolation, like how do we create the isolation of traffic between different tenants in the cloud deployment, and defining the networks through programming. The network services in multiple deployment model, like we have edge node, where the network node in the OpenStack, where the traffic comes from the internet, falls onto the network node, and then goes to the corresponding web application in the VM. And we have the another type of network application like OF controller, the layer 2, layer 7 support of OpenFlow controller. And we have a third type called virtual network functions, like running a virtual network function inside a virtual machine. So these are the three different models of network services, where we can create the services, we can insert the services, and chain the services together. And the configuration of these network services running inside a virtual machine is another important point, where, for example, we have the server load balancer, which is HAProxy. It is having its own configuration, like you have to configure all the pools of data and VIP, et cetera. And similarly for IP tables, we have all the policies required. This can be different in different types of deployment. Like, for example, policies are different in the network node. Policies are different for OF controller network applications deployed using OpenFlow controller networks or the virtual network functions based on the tenant networks. So how do we relay the configuration from OpenStack controller to these virtual functions running inside a virtual machine? So for edge network node, we have the JSON interface, the just REST API interface, where we can configure, relay this configuration data from OpenStack controller to the edge network node. And we have a resource manager for OpenFlow controller network applications, where we capture all the data from the configuration data of network functions to the OpenFlow controller network applications. And for virtual network functions, we have the relay agent. The relay agent is just another daemon which is running on the compute node where the network functions are running. So when you configure the network function from OpenStack controller, the configuration will get relayed through this JSON RPC messages, and it will capture by the relay agent on the compute node, and the relay agent will again use the libvirt whatIO serial to configure the network function inside the virtual machine. So these are the three different types of network services which we are required, and the configuration used for these network services. So this is the high-level picture for network services. So we have the OpenStack controller, we have OpenFlow controller, and OpenFlow controller, we have the cloud resource discovery consumer, and OpenFlow controller application service. And we have a firewall, web application firewall, and a server load balancer. We have the DB, where we configure all the data captured from this Neutron Nova through the cloud resource discovery. And the events from the database will be captured by the flow manager. And flow manager, using OpenFlow protocol, is going to configure the open vSwitch of compute nodes. And we have the network services like firewall, web application firewall, and server load balancer. They're running on the compute, they are in a virtual machines, inside the virtual machine running on a compute node. And we have web servers running on another compute node. So the corresponding flows which are required based on the events generated will be captured, and the flows will be pushed from the flow manager to the open vSwitch of compute nodes, where the network function and network services are running, and as well on the plain applications, like web applications or applications, web servers or applications or database type, the three type. So this is how the events generated by the Nova and Neutron will be captured and stored in a database of OpenFlow controller. And the intelligence built with this data from the database by the flow manager and pushes the flows required from to the open vSwitch on the compute nodes. So the flows will be configured from the flow manager whenever there's a miss packet generated by the open vSwitch connected to the open flow controller. The network services, here we have, those are all vendor neutral. Like we have network services can be from different vendors together, like or any open source applications as well. Like we don't need to use a specific vendor for network services. And the accelerators for virtual functions. So we need accelerators for these virtual functions to compare the performance of these virtual functions from the physical devices. So we have the network service chaining infrastructure where we can configure the network functions and we can create the chains, and we have dynamic networks creation for chaining, and we have the configuration, the network function configuration, where we will map the configuration and map this configuration to the network service chain, and then we will deploy the chain. And during this network service launch, chain launch, we have different issues, like we have the same host or the network functions inside a chain are two functions in one compute node and another function in another compute node. And also we have the migration support, where we will the network functions will be migrating from one compute to the another compute node. Yeah, the future work which we are planning to have is the layer 3 network service insertion and chaining support, and then network service statistics and elasticity. So excuse me. The statistics of networks, network functions. Based on the statistics generated by these network functions, the network services can be scaled up or scaled down, and elasticity of these network services, and dynamic launching of these network services based on the network function statistics, and multi-mode network services support, edge networks, like network node and OF controller application support for L4, L7 applications, and network services using network function virtualization. And also to improve the performance of network functions, the PCIe pass-through support for network service VMs. Yeah, a wide acceptance of OpenStack from commercial and open source communities. So that's why we started using OpenStack. And there is a need for cloud resource data, like to capture these events and use it for SDN kind of networks to deploy the network services, chaining and launching, and bringing in the OpenFlow controller into the OpenStack deployments is very much needed for so that the software-defined networking will be of better use. And the network services insertion and chaining framework, where we can create the network network chains and insert the network services and configure these network services, and versioning of this network services configuration as such. And multi-deployment modes, like deploying these network services in a network node are deploying these network services inside OpenFlow controller applications, or deploying these network services as a network function virtualization. Yeah, these are the guys behind this work. Like, we have Srini Adyapalli from, he's a fellow and chief software architect, and we have the manager, which is Sarath Babu, and we have the team, Trinad, Veera, Srikant, Sairam, and Ram Prasad, together to make this happen. Yeah, I'll take up questions now. We have the configuration relay mechanism, where we have the relay agent, which is running on a compute node. Excuse me. So the configuration done from OpenStack dashboard is relayed through the JSON messages to the compute nodes, and the relay agent is going to capture these messages and configure the network function. So it's a pretty good, like, we don't have any,
how many milliseconds?
We didn't count as such, we didn't see. But it's, we didn't see a big delay. I think it's a few milliseconds. Yeah, if that is the case, then it is true for all the components in the OpenStack as well. Like, we have Nova and Neutron. Nova, which will will launch the images, and Neutron, which will create the networks. They are coexisting together, and we don't see anything. We are in the proof of concept mode right now. Yeah, so we are not into the deployment. Just made a couple of network functions as a chain, and we deployed in our test networks. Okay, thank you.
Both working.
Yeah,
I moved